My favorite part of living in Tel Aviv, Israel, is being able to sit on top of our roof of our apartment and really just get to know each other and develop friendships and a family. I didn't know anybody when I came here, and now I feel like I really have amazing connections with everyone, just sitting underneath the stars, looking out over the ocean, and just getting to know one another and creating friendships and relationships that will hopefully translate on stage when we get to China.
Memories like the corners of my mind, misty watercolor memories of the way we were. Can it be that it was all so simple then, or has time rewritten every line? If we had the chance to do it all again,
here we are, right back where we started about 3 months ago. It's Thursday night, and 3 days from right now, we will be in China. So this is my last vlog entry from Israel. I really kind of can't believe it's time to leave already. Now, the good news is, I did save a few things to show you in this last episode. When we first got here, I said that there were two things that I wanted to do, and if I could do both of these things, this trip would be a roaring success. One was go to Jerusalem, and the other was to go to the Dead Sea. I did both. Ha ha! So, first I'm going to show you a tremendous day about a little over a month ago when I got together with Kelsey, Natalie, and Mallory, and we hopped a bus to Jerusalem. So we are now at the gate of Old Jerusalem and are about to go inside. So Old Jerusalem is divided into quarters, and right now we're in the Christian quarter on our way to the Jewish quarter, where we plan to have lunch and visit the Western Wall. And on the way from one quarter to another, they're so considerate, they make so you can shop. And in many ways, it's just like in Tel Aviv. You can actually buy frankincense and myrrh. So as you can see, we are now entering the Jewish quarter of Jerusalem. And at the entrance of the Jewish quarter, I don't know if you can read that, but this is called the Oil Press Gallery. And it's full of mosaics of famous Torah scenes. My hands are shaking a little bit because we are at the Western Wall in Jerusalem. I'm a little... Wow. Frankly, there are no words. There are no words. So I'll have to talk to you after I visit.
Eli. Eli. Shalom Yigamer. Ahor ve'ayah.
I just touched and kissed and prayed at the Wailing Wall. And it's a very powerful experience, I have to say. And I said Kaddish for Grandma Joan. And it's almost Rosh Hashanah, the start of a new year. And I'm very proud right now. Very proud of being a Jew. And now we are back in the Christian quarter, and we are in the Church of the Holy Sepulchre. And there's a lot of people around here, so I'm gonna bet that a mass just got out. But this is amazing.
Now, the Church of the Holy Sepulchre is a very important pilgrimage destination for Christians because it is venerated to be the site where Jesus was crucified, where he was anointed and laid in the tomb, and where he was resurrected. And it really is, being in that place, you know you're somewhere special.
Being in Jerusalem was an experience of a lifetime. There is this energy in Old Jerusalem, no matter what quarter you're in. And we only got to go to a couple of the quarters because we couldn't get into the Muslim quarter because it was during Ramadan, so unfortunately. But being there, period, and certainly being at the Wailing Wall, there is this undeniable energy that I don't think it would be possible to be there and not be affected or moved. So it was so great. And just 2 weeks ago, and I wasn't sure I was going to get to this one, but just 2 weeks ago, we had a last-minute day off, so I got to get together with Adam Chandler, Leslie, Natalie, Ryan, and Ryan's family, and we got to go to the Dead Sea. Now, I'm sorry, I didn't get to do a lot of filming. My battery was low, and quite frankly, I wanted to get in the water. So, this one I've only got pictures, but I think there's some pretty good pictures. First, we took a bus to Jerusalem, and then we got a bus from there to En Gedi, which is a beach-ish, because it's very rocky, but it's this great expanse of the Dead Sea where there's no lifeguards and you can just swim out. And I tell you, it's like swimming in jello. Some people say oil, I say jello, because it's impossible to sink. You feel like you're swimming in this kind of solid substance because there is so much salt in the Dead Sea that you can't go under. It just lifts you right back to the top. So we stayed in En Gedi for a while, and then we went to Mineral Beach, which is where you can do the mud, and I wanted to do the mud. The actual idea that they have these barrels of mud that they've scooped from right near where you are, and that you just want to reach in there with your hands and smear it all over your body, is just crazy. Who does that? Everyone that goes to Mineral Beach does that. It's awesome. And I tell you what, after you get all that mud off and you shower off the salt and all this stuff, your skin feels amazing. There is a reason people pay hundreds and hundreds of dollars for those spa treatments.
And of course, I had to see if I could be like Moses and part the sea. Didn't work. Sorry.
I have loved being here so much, and I recommend for anyone who gets the chance to come here, no matter what religion you are, because you're gonna find some wonderful things here. So that's it for Israel. And the next time you see me, I will be broadcasting from China. Oh, here we go. But once again, thank you for watching. Thank you for letting me show you Israel. I can't wait to show you China. Thanks for sticking with me through this adventure. I love you for watching. Bye.